me! Capitan! Four left! Capitan! Capitan! Wait for me!
Get off! Take the seat! Leave it! Leave it!
Capitan! In Pila only! Hold it!
Come on!
You dirty, stinking French dog!
Hello, didn't they go? Didn't they care?
You saw me coming, but you'd have me stay there and rot for another year.
Since when does a Kanaka eat with white men?
When a man loses his own self-respect, he has no respect for others.
Speak for yourself, Van Hook. You and your Kanaka wife and your half-breed kids. And you, whoever you are. Out here, we keep Kanakas in their place. Don't let them mainland clothes fool you. He's a Kanaka.
Tell me, how long have you been out here?
What's that got to do with it?
Oh, I just wondered.
I've been here 10 years. 10 years too long.
Well, it's strange, then, that you know so little about the Polynesians.
I know all there is to know.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I'm new out here myself, but I do know that the Polynesians are Caucasians, even as you and I.
You trying to tell me we're the same? That Kanaka and me?
I am. Like it or not, here's your brother.
Brother? Him?
Capitan! 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 Stop him! He's gonna throw me to the shark!
That is good. Throw him. The sharks will vomit.
I'm going up forward. The air is fresher there.
How come he speaks English good?
We went to the same university.
University? School?
Yeah.
Then he's Tenga.
That's right. That's his name.
I know all about him. He ain't no Kanaka. He's quarter white. His grandpa was a white man.
Makes a big difference, eh?
His grandpa was a Yankee skipper that got rescued by Tenga's people. They thought he was a god. The blue-eyed one, they called him. He got himself a wench, and he had a kid. Taught him all English.
Is he still alive?
Nah. Rescue ship took him back to the States years ago. Made a fortune. He died. He left all that money to this Tenga. He's a very rich man.
No, you're wrong. Tenga gave it away.
Gave it away? You mean he spent it?
No, he gave it to the college.
What for?
Tenga didn't like what he saw, what we call civilization. And as the months went by, he came to know the meaning of homesickness. So he left the money. Be used in the future by any other student from a faraway place who wants to go home.
Can you see the island?
Not yet, but already I can smell it.
So can I. That's a miracle.
No, it was always so. The trade winds carry the smell of the flowers out to sea.
I mean, your people will be very surprised to see you.
No, no, they will know I am coming.
How can they? This is the first boat in a year.
That's true, but they will know. We call it the bamboo telegraph. It is not known how the word moves across the water, but my people will know.
The island. Tenga! Tenga!
And still they come. My sister, Kalua, the blue-eyed one. Kalua!
She will not be able to speak to you, my friend. And you may not speak to her. It is yet taboo.
Tell your people keep away! They will be killed!
My sister tells me the kahuna has warned them that a white one was coming.
What does it mean? Who is the kahuna?
He's a sacred one. He's like a prophet.
Tenga, get your people off! We will capsize!
The outrigger boys will bring our sea chests. Come, we will save the schooner! We will swim!
Got a very warm welcome.
Maybe the kahuna made a mistake. Maybe he thought it was you was coming ashore.
Seem wet. Look at yourself. Doesn't matter. It's the last time we'll wear these clothes. It was he who gave the warning. It was the kahuna. Now you look like one of us.
Not quite. I can't get this thing to stay on. I've been trying it out, running around the room, but it falls off. It could be embarrassing.
Why? Nakedness is what the gods wore. Marlow is an easy thing to fasten. Try it.
It works.
Oh, there is something I want to ask you. This fella, the kahuna you called him, is he apt to cause trouble? Because I wouldn't want your people to think I was bad luck.
They await the word of the chief, my father. Whatever the chief tells my people, they will accept.
He has more power than the kahuna?
Yes. He descends from the ancestral gods of my people. He is the firstborn, the chief, the high priest. Through him flows the manna of the gods. His word is our law.
Then will he see me?
Yes, I have just come from him. When the big drum calls, I am to bring you there.
Now, you have given me your house. Where will you live?
I will show you. In the common house. I will stay there. It is customary for young men who have been chosen.
Chosen?
But the girl's eligible to marry. No one knew it chose me before I went away. She has waited for my return. Now we will live in the common house.
Oh, that's the place for the young married people.
No, no. For those who hope to marry. It is there we find out if we will be happy together.
If you're not.
Then we leave the common house.
And try again?
It is important that marriage be right and good. We do not have divorce here. Unless the woman is without child.
I have another question.
Yes?
Your sister.
Kalua is no question.
But the blue of her eyes.
For my grandfather. Mine have some of it, too.
Very beautiful. Yet I may not speak to her.
No. Nor can any unmarried young man in the village until she is offered.
Offered? For what?
For marriage.
And who decides when she's ready?
My mother. It is a ceremony. The drum will sound soon. You will bear your gifts to the chief. And you may throw away the key. Locks are not needed here.
Now, what gifts are appropriate for this first visit?
The binoculars for the chief. The turquoise velvet for his wife. Velvet will be like a miracle. It has not been seen in this place. And the spectacles for the Iwakuamo'o, the chief's man. He is old and nearly blind. The spectacles will give him wonder and please him. It will make him your friend. That is good. He has the chief's ear.
What'll I do? Just hand them over with my best wishes? Do they understand English?
Why, certainly. My father's father was on this island for more than 2 years. My people thought he was a god, learned his way of talking. They've taught their children. We do not have books here, but we have good remembering. It is the gift of Apo. Come, the drum sounds. With us, gift-giving has a special meaning. We believe there is a spirit within the gift, mana, that flows from the giver to the receiver, brings them closer together. That is why we touch the gifts to our heads. This is my friend. He is called Andre. He comes in friendship bearing gifts. He has a gift for you. Very expensive. My friend will show you the magic of it.
It is said your eyes are old. Well, this is magic, to make them see close and far away again.
Good. It is good. You got gift for chief?
Very expensive. Cost much money.
Why do you keep saying how much things cost?
It's the customer. Pleases the one who gets the gift and makes the giver proud. Time has come. Remember, if the chief is standing, bow. If he is seated, kneel. The head of the chief is tapu, sacred. No one looks down on the chief.
You come here in friendship?
Yes.
My son has told me that your eyes and your heart are open.
I bring gifts.
They are expensive gifts. They cost very, very much on the big island across the waters. With these, my father can see distances better than any man.
Telescope?
Two telescopes, father. See twice as far.
This is for the mother of my friend.
As chief of my people, my son's friend is welcome here. Our home, our village, everything that we have is yours. I will tell the people to prepare the feast.
Faina!
For women to eat with men. It's through women and food that evil passes most easily.
Well, this is delicious. What is it?
Octopus.
Where is the chief?
He is served by the old man with the spectacles. No other may touch his food. This is Noah Noah.
The one who chose you?
Yes.
Can I say hello to her?
Of course.
Hello.
Hello.
She made that specially for you?
Yes.
It's a nice compliment.
My sister wears a red flower. When we are seeking love, we wear a white flower. But when love makes our heart beat fast, we wear a red flower. If our love tires, we wear a green thing.
May I accept this from her?
Certainly.
But I can't say hello.
No. My sister wants you. In our language, there is no word for love. The words she wants you mean the same thing, only more.
Well, if I wanted her too, what could I do about it?
Nothing. But you could let her know. It would make her happy, I think.
But how can I let her know unless I tell her? And that's forbidden.
Let your eyes speak as hers did to you.
But what about these other young men? I could end up having a coconut cracked over my head.
No, there is no word for jealousy in our language either. If anyone takes life that seriously here, he is either a fool or he is sick.
Hey, there, my
Kahuna, you have called up Powell. The people are gone. Speak.
I've said the white man would come. He has come. And with him came the thunder. The clouds were dark. I have looked into waters and into the fire. I have seen evil there. This white one brings evil with him. He must go from this place.
Hear me, Kahuna. On the big island of America, I came a stranger. There was no one of my kind. This man came from the land of France.
He was a stranger, too. But it was he who first gave me his hand, who gave me friendship in the lonely place. He is as my brother.
It is good that he gave you friendship on the Big Island. But he has come here, and his coming has brought evil signs. Through them the gods have spoken. He must go.
May I speak? I'm not here to stay, but as a visitor. I come in friendship, and I will respect your ways. And I promise you, I bring no evil with me. Do the gods know I'm just here on a vacation?
The boat that bore him here is gone. The sun will set 100 times before it returns. Surely no hurt can come from my friend.
You're the firstborn. Blood of the gods is in you. You're greater than any other. I have given you the signs. I have spoken of their meaning. The deciding is for you.
We have made the White One welcome here. He has no way to return to his people. He shall stay. Perhaps the gods will look into your heart and find it good.
For a minute, I thought I'd have to start swimming.
Do not blame the kahuna for his feelings. When he was very young, white traders came here with guns. They left behind them smallpox and many dead. Kahuna's an old man now, but he is not forgotten.
I see. But what about you? Do you believe in his signs? The thunder, the water, the fire?
Yes. These things rule our lives. We live by the sea, the sky, and the winds. These things we understand. They speak to us. Sleep well, my friend. But until the signs change, be careful. Do not let the kahuna get anything that is yours. Of your body or of food that you have eaten. He has the magic. He can pray a man to his death.
Tenga. Do you actually believe he can do that?
I have seen it.
Thank you. What happened?
It is clear you have no mana with the sea.
Mana?
It is given to us at the sacred pool. The men on it speaks to us and guides us.
Do you think it would work for me?
Of course.
Well, lead me to it. Where is it?
Oh, no. No, you must go there alone. Maybe tomorrow. I will tell you the way.
It is forbidden. But I wanted to speak your name. I saw you coming this way, so I followed. I have broken the taboo, but I could not help it.
I want to be with you, with all my heart. But I don't want harm to come to you, or to your brother. He has trust in me.
I know. And I've done a bad thing. But if I go quickly to the kahuna, he will heal me.
Must you go to him?
Yes. Everywhere evil spirits wait for those who break the taboo. But if I go swiftly to him, he will make me know.
You're sure I have mana now?
Yes.
I have graduated.
Yes. I think you are ready for a journey alone.
Where to?
That moat.
That little island?
Yes. There was a storm in the night. After a storm, sharks are hungry and attack. Beware.
Do they like white meat?
It is said they prefer it.
Hello. Your name is Laurent. Glad to have you aboard.
How did you know my name?
A seagull told me. No, come to think of it, it was an albatross.
How long have you been here?
12, 14, 16 years, something like that.
Where did you come from?
From the same place you did.
From the island?
They kicked me out long ago. Join me in a drink. Appreciate your coming to call.
Picture girl, yeah?
Where?
Over on the island. Well, I certainly found one I like, but...
But what?
She's not ready for marriage.
Oh, you're particular. Drink hearty. Both of them, eh?
What is it?
Learn to make it in the Marquesas. Namawehi. Comes from the coconut blossom. Get a gallon a week. Don't be particular.
Oh, I'm not particular. It just blisters on the way down.
I mean about picking a woman. A wench is a wench.
Now, the girl I speak of is not a wench.
Oh. Good girl, eh?
No woman is good until she's a grandmother.
Came out here for the adventure, didn't you?
Well, in a way, I...
So did I.
Fell for the place. The people. A girl. So I stayed on.
You staying?
The schooner would pick me up.
Yes, I know. But will you leave on it when it comes? You won't. Found paradise, haven't we? I let the schooner sail away, too. And I was sure I was doing the right thing. Farewell forever to cities and their filth. Escape to paradise. Eden. Utopia. Nothing to work for. Nothing to live for. Except pleasure. True?
Is that wrong?
No. As the years pass, you'll see that it's not easy to do nothing well. Living among savages is exciting at first.
But these people are not savages.
No? Wait till they make you taboo. Kick you out. If I ever set foot on that island again, they'd kill me.
No, that's very hard to believe.
All right. Don't believe it. Here's to the dream. Don't wake up, Lawrence. Enjoy it as long as you can. Mai! Vicky, Vicky! Mai! Vicky, Vicky! Mai! Vicky, Vicky! Mai! Vicky, Vicky! Vicky, Vicky! Mine. All of them. They come with a dream. And they don't even know my name.
Why are they frightened?
Because the dreams are fake. Because we're closer to hell in this place than to paradise. I've taught them that. I've taught them fear and showed them darkness.
When hell takes them, they'll be ready.
How can you take vengeance on children?
Before you try to tell me what's in me, find out first what's in you. Forgive me. You still think there's beauty here. This I can teach you. I'll tell you what's beautiful. It's all the things you've left. All the things I'll never see again. The gleam of a gaslight on a cobbled street. Cold winds and falling snow. Voices of friends. The sound of carriage wheels in the night. The laughter of your own kind of women. Not these soft-eyed native wenches who grow old as fast as the sun goes down. Not like the mother of these brats who come crawling back to you like a dog, even after you've beaten it near to death.
Where is the children's mother?
As I said, she'll come crawling back. He always does. Laurence, don't pay any attention to what I said. Remember, nobody's good, all good. And nobody's bad, all bad. Everybody's both. Enjoy the dream while you can. It's a beautiful dream.
Why did you send me to that place, Tanger?
Many years ago, that man, the bad one, came here and was received in friendship, as was my grandfather and you.
Then why was he sent away?
His heart was evil. He was cruel to his woman. And he broke our taboos.
When you sent me to that place, you knew I had spoken to your sister.
The kahuna told my father, the chief. You have been here 3 weeks. We are not blind. When my sister came back from the kahuna, she was changed. We saw that. She no longer smiles at the young men who will someday offer their hearts and their dwellings to her. You have come here as my friend. You've been made welcome by my father. When you leave, you must leave in friendship and in honor.
Tanga, as I came back to your island today, my mind was filled with many things. But most of all, that each man is but one life. And he must ask himself what he means to do with it.
Go on.
While alone out there, I found the answer. My heart has taken root on your island. I want to stay here.
Stay here and what?
I want your sister.
What of your people across the waters?
The schooner will carry my message.
You're willing to give up your life in your native country for us?
If you will have me, yes.
You're making a serious decision, you know that. Once it is made because of my sister, there could be no regrets ever.
I know.
You've seen the bad one, what it is like for him.
Yes. A man reaps what he sows. I know I will find happiness here. And I will try to give it.
You will not like what I'm going to say. It is my belief that while your intentions are honorable and your love for Kalua and my people is very real, you will fail.
Why do you say that?
Because I do not believe that you or any white man could ever fully become one of us. Any more than I could ever have completely become one of your civilized world. Why did I quit the university after so short a time to come back to my island? I wanted to learn, I studied, I walked and talked with the others, those of your world. But in here, I knew there were things that would always be strange to me. Things I could never accept or even understand. Did you know that? And so it is here with you. There are things that have come to our world through thousands of years of our way of life. But you will never be able to understand or accept. We are friends, Andre. But we are of two different worlds. What is in us has been born in us. It cannot be changed.
I think it can. If the wish is strong enough. If the love is great enough. I must confess something about me that you didn't know. I did not come here with you just for a vacation, thank you. Oh, yes, it was part of it, but not all of it. This you know, that I'm the son of a very rich man. Within reason, I can do or buy most anything. However, I've been searching for something. In Europe, in America, in many places. Something that cannot be bought. It must be earned. But I found it here with your people. It's a way of life where all hearts are open, where the most important virtue is kindness. Yes. I want to stay here, very much.
I will speak to my parents of all you have said here. The signs of the kahuna must be erased. My father and I will make sacrifices at the high place. We will pray. If the signs speak well, if you are permitted to stay, and are one with my sister, I will be happy.
Thank you.
This I must also tell you. If you fail, Kalua, if you fail my people, I will kill you. Look, Father. It is the best of signs. They have spoken.
Kalua's time has come. Tonight she will be offered.
What do I do?
But tonight she makes her choice. You want to be chosen.
More than anything in the world.
Well, then get in the circle with the unmarried men. Hurry!
So close. Make room for Kalua beside you.
But I haven't had a chance to talk to her. How do I know she'll choose me? Look at them. She's known these others all her life.
She wants you.
But suppose she gets cold feet, changes her mind.
And you're out of luck.
Thank you.
Such deep meaning to me that I say them for the first time. I love you beyond anything in the world.
From now on, we will be together.
My daughter has made her choice. They go to the common house.
Where do they go?
Beyond the rock. If there are more than two here, the girls go bathe together. It's the custom.
Tanga, when can I have Kalua to myself in our own house?
You're ready for marriage so soon?
Well, perhaps it's my French blood.
You're very impulsive. With us, we think about it longer.
Think about it? Last night I couldn't sleep.
We say desire eats sleep. But it is our custom to spend some time in the common house.
Is it also a custom, on the first night there, to have your hair pulled out by the roots?
Why do you say that?
But it happened to me last night.
It was the kahuna. It was the magic to take away your mind. It's a strong curse. He has done this before.
And it worked?
Yes. He did it also to the bad one, the one you saw. Mine was dark for months. Noah, Noah! We should not wait. We must find him before the sun sets on the curse.
I come to ask you to lift the curse on my friend.
Speak not to me. Speak to those up there.
My father has spoken.
I know that.
A rainbow came. That is a good sign.
What about other signs? Bad ones.
What signs will you believe to make my sister and my friend as one?
The fire.
My people do not kiss this way.
Don't you like it?
Yes. Did French girls teach you how?
Oh, no. No Frenchmen just seem to learn how as they grow up. It comes natural.
The girl does not help to learn.
Well, yes. It does take two.
Two. You and me. Let's do it again.
I have seen the kahuna. He calls for the purification.
The walking on fire?
He says it is the one way to prove that your union with Andre is good.
Then I will do it.
What is this walking on fire?
It is a very old ceremony. If the one who walks on fire is not burned, all the people know the gods approve.
And Kalu will do this?
I will do it for us.
But suppose the kahuna is angry at her because of me, that he wants to punish her, burn her.
It will not burn if you have faith. It will not burn.
Bad ones are burned, and their burns do not heal. Kalua is good. You will not understand, my friend, but she will walk on the fire and she will not be burned. I will tell the kahuna.
Tenga! Up to this moment, I have accepted your beliefs, no matter what my private thoughts were about them. But this will endanger Kalua, and I will not accept it.
The accepting is for her. She has looked into our heart and she has agreed.
But what if she's burned?
If your heart is dark, she will be.
But this is barbaric. You have education, Tenga.
You've seen the other world. As our brother, you should not allow it.
You asked to share our life and our ways. You asked to become one of us. I warned you it would not be easy. This firewalking is part of our life. We have faith in our gods as you have in yours. My sister wants to go to the fire to prove that your love is good. Before the people, before the kahuna. Before our gods. If you do not accept this, you must leave us now, this day.
Andre, if we are to marry, I must do it. I want to. You will not leave.
And if you stay, you will watch. It is required. You will make no move. You will not cry out. If you do, my sister will be burned.
You're not burned.
No. I did not feel the fire.
But I stood there. I saw the fire in the stones. This is incredible.
We have the answer. The gods have smiled on us. Now we can be one. Now you can buy me.
Buy you?
Yes, from my father. It is the custom. I will be very expensive.
You will be worth it.
Laurence. Why have you come here?
I saw the smoke in the sky. I knew what it meant. I came to warn you. They took my woman to that pit. She walked on those stones. You didn't see her when you came. But to this day, her burns hadn't healed.
You were good to come. But the ceremony is over. Kalua was not hurt. Now you must go, quickly. I'll help you to launch the boat.
Don't need help. Besides, one can be seen less than two. And my taboo may come off on you.
Hungry! Hungry! I have a guinea!
Thanks for coming to warn me.
If things change, come and see me. It's lonely out there.
Andre, is there a core gone?
A core?
The evil thing that was there, the head.
Yes, he's gone.
You were brave to face him.
You've never seen him before?
Oh, no.
What is the meaning of those sounds?
The death taboo has been broken. That is why the spirit was here. The Akua.
What does the stillness mean?
The Akua has been found and killed.
It is well known that my daughter Kalua is the finest flower of the island.
Kalua is the finest flower of the island, of the Pacific, of the world. She is beyond price.
Aye, it is true. She is beyond price. Yet you come to buy her.
Could I buy the sun? Could I buy the moon? No. All these wonderful things are beyond price. Well, so it is with your daughter Kalua.
You speak well. These gifts are the best you can offer.
I give my father my word. Of all the rich gifts in the possession of my friend, these are the best. And they cost a fortune.
Then he has more to choose from?
Of course he has. He is a rich man. If he were not, how would he dare ask for Kalua? But some of the gifts must be saved for the gods. They may be blessed with children. It is the custom.
That is true. If there are no children, you may bring your wife back to this place, and all gifts will be returned.
But there will be children. Immediately. The gifts will be forever yours, my father.
Then Kalua will be his.
She's yours. Follow me. She's in there. Follow me. Don't look back.
I wish you happiness.
Now, did you bring me all this way just to say that?
Of course not. The kidnapping begins here. It is the custom.
The what?
The kidnapping.
Who kidnaps who?
You will kidnap Kalua.
Tanga, some of your customs are fine, and I want to learn them all. But why must I kidnap my bride?
In your country, does not the groom run off with the bride?
That's not kidnapping.
It would bring great shame to the chief if he let his best daughter go easily. She must be taken from him by force.
But I don't need to take Kalua by force. She wants to come with me. She loves me.
That is true. But when you kidnap her, she will fight you and bite you. It is the custom. It proves that she loves her parents. It proves that she does not willingly run from their happy house.
But she is willing, isn't she?
Of course she is. As soon as you kidnap her, the big drum will sound the alarm. My father will rush out in anger because someone has stolen his daughter.
But he just gave her to me.
And I will rush out with my weapons.
You will rush?
Because someone has stolen my sister. And all of our warriors will come with their weapons. And we will look for you. We'll look everywhere.
Where will I be?
You will have carried Kalua into your house.
But that's the first place anybody would look.
Yes. But we will not find you. That is the custom, too. It is the chase and the excitement that makes everyone feel good. Everyone knows that the chief did not give up his daughter easily. Everyone is proud. Everyone is happy. It is a good custom.
Then what happens?
Then you and your bride will be tapu in your dwelling for 2 weeks. For 2 weeks, no one may speak to you or disturb your honeymoon. Food will be brought to your door each morning. Also flowers. It is the custom here that the honeymoon be devoted to love.
Tanga, I take back everything I have said about your custom. They're wonderful.
The time has come.
For what?
The kidnapping. There she goes. I must not know that you're going to steal her. Farewell.
Come on! signs are clear.
What do you see in the water, Kahuna? What does it say?
Your daughter will be forever barren. The child will never come to them.
Andre, I brought you a new wife. She is as my sister. You will like her.
But I didn't ask for a new wife.
She will give you babies.
Look here, Kalua. Are you happy with me?
I am terrible happy.
Well, I'm happy with you. You're all the wife I want and ever dreamed of having.
But I have no baby.
But we've only been married 3 months. Some people wait years for babies.
Everybody is looking at me. My father looks at me. I know they are saying she is not having a baby. I know it.
I don't care whether they are or not. You're my wife and I'm happy. And I don't want another wife. I mean no offense. You would make a wonderful wife, I'm sure. Wonderful. But I love Kalua. I mean, I want Kalua.
But you would still have me, Andre. When there are no babies, it is permitted to have two wives.
But I wouldn't know what to do with two wives. Where I come from, one is enough.
But if there are no babies?
But they wait a decent length of time to find out. Then, if they have no babies, they can adopt one.
Your wife must give you a baby.
If I don't have one with you, I won't have one with anybody.
But I would still be your number one wife, Andre, and she would be number two. She is my dear friend. We would both try to make you very happy.
Now, you know you wouldn't want to be just a number two wife, would you?
Yes.
No, you wouldn't. You are very pretty. You must sit beside a fine young man and be his number one wife.
I'll be your number two.
It's wrong of you to bring this girl here without asking me. And don't cry. I just don't want to hurt your feelings, but I don't want... Just that I have so much love in my heart for Kalua. There is no more to give another. Take her home now. And when you come back, I have a gift for you. Soap from Paris, France.
Seen. Our girls like to smell good.
You are the cleanest people on earth.
That's because we have great mana for the waters. The sea and the sky are our brothers.
Oh,
turns to blood. This is the worst time.
Come to the village! Hey, Alakini! Hey, Alakini! Hey, Alakini!
Your presence here angers the guards.
I will not leave Kalua.
Please, Andre. Your being here will bring danger to my people. Do as the governor says.
If there is danger, I want to be with you.
You must go.
Go to our house. Wait there for me.
She is my sister. She will be by my side. Leave now, my friend. Now.
Thank you.
sacrifice.
Only the firstborn daughter of the chief can silence the anger. Kalua, make ready.
I have loved and been loved. I am ready. I will go up there and bring our people peace.
You gave us great joy, my little one. We are all but a part of something endless. One day we will meet again in the long sleep.
It seems worse than ever. There are rivers of lava.
They will slow and stop and cool. The gods will smile on us forever. I came here to tell you that.
Are you going back to that place?
I must, for my people.
I will go with you.
No. No, you cannot. You must remain here.
But if a new river comes...
If there is any fear in your heart, I want to take it away.
My only fear is for you.
There's little time, my beloved, but listen well. To us, death is nothing. We come from nowhere. And if we are blessed, we find joy, as I have found it with you. Then we die. But we're not afraid. For we know that all things die except the sea. Only the sea goes on. And it does not remember. I must go now, my dearest one. Kiss me once more. In our way.
Stay because you ask me. But tell Tanga, if it nears the high place, I will come.
Feel the flames.
carrying with me grief and an empty heart. But for all my hurt, I also carry the memory of moments I shall never forget as long as I live. I will remember Tanga proudly riding the wave to the shore. The joy that even the old people knew. The laughter of the young. And the openness of their hearts. Their dignity and their generosity. And their eagerness to share happiness. But most of all, and forever, wherever I go, to the end of my life, I will carry with me my love for Kalua. Kalua, my beloved.